This is a brief video explaining how the Mile High Flood District's Detention Basin Design Workbook can be used to evaluate underground storage for water quality and flood control. My name is Derek Rapp, and I'm going to walk you through an example that evaluates an underground storage system that was originally designed using proprietary software provided by the product manufacturer. This example video is based on a Stormtech Chamber manufactured by ADS, but the concept applies to any type of underground storage product. Use of the Stormtech Chamber in this example does not imply endorsement of the product by the Mile High Flood District. The Stormtech Chamber consists of an open bottom arch pipe, which provides the bulk of the flood storage. These chambers are then covered with crushed, angular stone, which can provide some additional storage in the void space. Many of the product manufacturers also provide their own sizing tools to help calculate the storage volume provided within the chambers and the stone void space based on user input constraints. For this example, we have a Stormtech spreadsheet for a two-row chamber design which calculates the stage volume relationship. The stage is shown in inches and the storage volume is shown in cubic feet. We can see that at the top of the storage zone, the maximum volume is 6,470 cubic feet, or approximately 0.15 acre feet. This table also accounts for 9 inches of gravel storage below the chambers and 12 inches of gravel storage above the chambers. At this point, the user is faced with the problem of how to incorporate this stage volume relationship into the district's detention basin design workbook in order to route the design storms through the underground storage facility and evaluate the outlet structure drain times. I will now open up the design workbook to the basin worksheet and demonstrate how to evaluate this underground storage facility. For the purposes of this example, we will assume that water quality is provided upstream of the facility, and the objectives for storage are to release runoff consistent with the full spectrum detention methodology. For this reason, we will model the underground storage consistent with an extended detention basin. However, the Mile High Flood District does not recommend underground extended detention as a substitute for water quality treatment. The tributary watershed is a small commercial project with an area just over 1 acre and an imperviousness of 76%. The CUHP runoff volumes for the watershed are shown here, and the estimated detention storage volumes based on empirical equations are shown here. The approximate 100-year detention volume is 0.13 acre-feet, slightly less than the 0.15 acre-feet provided in the underground storage design. If we scroll down to the bottom, you can see that the design will include three zones representing the water quality capture volume, excess urban runoff volume, and 100-year event. Now we have reached the point where we need to incorporate the stage volume relationship for the underground facility. The automated sizing method below that is based on entering a few input constraints, such as depth, slope, and shape, will not work for the arch pipe and gravel pore space configuration. Therefore, we will need to provide user overrides for the stage area relationship in the table. However, the Stormtech spreadsheet only provides the stage volume relationship. Any attempt to manually back calculate the area at each stage from the known volume and arch pipe geometry would be challenging and would not account for the pore space in the gravel around the chambers. Fortunately, this workbook includes a tool that will allow you to automatically back-calculate the stage area relationship from a known stage volume relationship by using an algorithm to minimize the sum of squared differences between known volumes and calculated volumes. In order to use this tool, we need to convert the values from the Stormtech spreadsheet to feet and acre feet and then condense the table to fewer rows. I have already performed this step and have pasted the values here in half-foot increments. The maximum volume is approximately 0.15 acre feet. By clicking this button, the program will attempt to calculate a stage area relationship that will match the known stage volume relationship. The algorithm will start by picking a bottom area and then iteratively solving for an area in each row to match the corresponding volumes. It will then repeat this procedure with a different bottom area until it finds the best fit. When I click the button, you can see the iterations being evaluated in the status bar in the lower left corner. When a reasonable solution is found, a message box will appear and notify you that the bottom area can be further refined to get a better fit if desired. If we look at the volume columns, we see that the program has found an almost exact match within the precision tolerance of the algorithm. However, when we look at the chart, we can see oscillations in the area values which are plotted as a green line. We can try to smooth this out by slightly modifying the starting bottom area. I will try increasing it to 600 square feet, and the program will automatically update all subsequent rows. We see that this smoothed the green line a little bit. I will increase it again to 610 square feet. That creates a very smooth line, and if you think about the geometry of the inverted arches and the gravel storage below and above the chambers, it is a good representation of the actual storage area being provided. The bottom 9 inches of storage just accounts for the pore space in the gravel. Then, above that, we get the widest cross-section of the Stormtech chamber. This open area cross-section begins to decrease as we move up to the top of the chamber, and then it reverts back to just pore space in the gravel above. Now we can click this button to copy the stage area relationship back to the basin worksheet automatically. When the values are copied over and the workbook is updated, the program will automatically take us back to the Basin Worksheet. We can see that the stage area volume table has now been populated and the Basin Worksheet is complete. We will now switch over to the Outlet Structure Worksheet. I have already completed the outlet structure design for this example using the same approach detailed in other videos, but we'll quickly review the inputs and router results. An orifice plate was selected for zones 1 and 2 to slowly release the excess urban runoff volume. A vertical orifice was selected to control the release rate of the 100-year storm in zone 3. The orifice plate openings were determined by clicking the automated sizing button and letting the program solve for open area. For the 100-year release rate, a vertical orifice was iteratively sized to release the 100-year event at 90% of the pre-development peak flow rate. This was achieved with a 6-inch diameter orifice. If we scroll down and look at the routed hydrograph results table, we see that the excess urban runoff volume drains out in 58 hours and the ponding depth is approximately 3.55 feet. When we look at the 100-year design storm results, we see that it is being released at 90% of pre-development peak flows and the storage volume required fits within the Stormtech chamber volume of approximately 0.15 acre feet. You may also notice that the 500-year design storm exceeds the available volume. That is fine because the inlet to the underground storage facility is not designed to capture the 500-year event, and some of the flow bypasses the inlet. We can also take a look at the inflow and outflow hydrographs to get a sense for how the various storms are routed through the underground storage facility. We can see the level of attenuation provided for each storm. That concludes this video. I hope it was helpful in understanding how the workbook can be used for underground storage. Be sure to check out the other instructional videos available.